Monita,
by Celestine, Trinidad.
Alex wondered if she could blame the alcohol, or the sleepless night she had just had before the party, or exhaustion from the mission and all the exams, but she felt as if she was dreaming when Sam called her name. She had walked to the front of the room to receive her gift, and he pulled her in for a hug. She buried her face in his hair, breathing in his scent. He smelled of soap, with just a hint of perfume. It was something familiar, something pleasant, but also something she never noticed until now. Like a lot of things about him. Numbly, she thanked him and announced the name for only a moment. Alex walked toward the back of the room, at first thinking to go back to the mobile bar, but she walked out of the rooftop instead. She rode the elevator down to the ground floor and ran out of the building. Once she was finally outside, she took a long, deep breath. She was still clutching her gift, but made no move to open it. She was afraid.
You don't like it?
She whirled around with a start. Sam was standing behind her, his face in shadow. God, Sam, I almost had a heart attack. She said, don't do that. You know how jumpy I've been since the haunting at Crystal Park. Sam managed to laugh, although awkwardly.
Crystal, correct me if she heard that. Heart attack is such a lame-ass term. Call it myocardial infarction.
He stuffed his hands in his pockets.
But seriously, don't you want to open your gift?
I do want to open it, she said. Wait. She tried to open her gift, but her fingers were shaking so hard that she couldn't even hold the box properly. Sam reached out for her hands and said,
Alex, let me.
He murmured. Alex let go of the box. Her skin still tingled from where his fingers had brushed gently against hers. And she took deep breaths to stop the blood from spitting. He finished opening the gift. He brought out a tumbler from Salt and Pepper Cafe, which was what she had asked for in the Kris Kringle's wish list, and a new gray messenger bag, the same brand and color of the one she uses now.
I really thought she needed a new bag,
he said.
So I went ahead and got one for you. You have this tendency to keep using your old things, even when you should already start replacing them. And don't tell me you don't have enough time to buy things, because I know you do.
It's just so comfortable to keep using my old things, she said. Why replace them when they were just fine?
Sometimes new is better, Alex.
His brown eyes held hers, his gaze intense, full of meaning. But I don't want things to change. It's when things get worse if they do change. I really thought you got Cecilia, she said. I only figured it out after you gave me the third gift. I did like all of the gifts, though. I really did. It's just really unexpected.
Unexpected that I would know how to give good gifts?
Not that, Alex said. That I thought you'd be that happy again.
Why won't I be? Alex?
Sam said. Because Alex choked on the lump in her throat that informed she hesitated. Because I'm not Cecilia, she clenched her fists. I mean, why would you mess up this chance you now have with her? And things were going along so well, you were finally spending time with her, dating her, and...
We're not dating, Alex.
Sam said quietly.
I'm sorry I couldn't clear things up. She told me not to tell anyone, not even you. She knew that she wasn't doing just be crazy, and she didn't want to just jinx anything. We're not dating, okay?
Then what were you doing? He looked at his watch.
Yeah, it's about time.
What?
I want to show you what I've been working on.
He said.
Come with me, and I'll explain everything.
He held out a hand. Alex hesitated.
Don't you trust me?
He said. He kept his hand in the air. Alex sighed and took his hand. I do so, she said. I know this. I still do, despite everything. His fingers entwined around hers.
Thank you.
Monita, Monita.
Bye, Celestine.